Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss chapter number 4 of class 8 that is force and pressure. First of all, let us define force. What do we mean by force? In the previous classes, you have read that any type of push or pull is called force. But here you have to add something in the definition. So you may define force like any push or pull which causes change in state of motion and configuration of any body. State of motion means if you are applying the force on a body and if the body is at rest, if then the position of the body will change, it will shifted into motion, it will move. State of motion, rest to motion. If the body is at rest and you are pushing in the direction, you are applying the force in the direction of motion of the body, then what will happen? Its speed will increase, it will speed up. If the force is applied from opposite side, opposite to the direction of motion, what will happen? The speed of the body will decrease. Similarly, if the body is at rest and two forces are applied or applied from other sides, then what will happen? The body will change its configuration, shape. Configuration means shape and size. It will change the shape and size. Body, due to application of the force, body may change the direction of motion also. So I think you have a clear cut definition regarding force, that any push or pull which causes change in the state of motion and configuration of the body is called force. What are the types of the forces? My dear student, it has only two types. Names will be different, but it is categorizes into two types. One is contact force and other is non-contact force. Non-contact force is also known as action at a distance force. So contact force is a force which is applied with the help of the contact, with the help of the touching the body. Without physical contact, that force cannot be applied. But non-contact force is a force which will act from distance without touching the body. So contact force, let me define each part of the force. Contact force is the force which comes in act due to the physical contact between the two objects. It has many types. Name of the contact force is given here. Many types of contact forces are there. We may name that like pulling force. If you are pulling any object by touching, it is the pulling force. If you are pushing, then it is pushing force. Balanced force, in unbalanced force, friction or force of friction, normal force, muscular force, tangential force, elongative force, etc. There are so many names given to this contact force. Similarly, now we can define non-contact force, that means action at a distance force, which comes into play with without any physical contact, without any touch. It acts from a distance. Therefore, it is termed as non-contact force. It has following types: gravitational force, magnetic force, electrostatic force or electric force. Gravitational force is the force acting between the two objects due to the mass, or acting between the earth and sun, acting between the earth and any object. And magnetic force is a force which acts between the two magnet or magnet and magnetic material. Similarly, electrostatic force is a force which is applicable between the charges of the body. It acts between the two charges. You will study, or you may have studied that like charges repels each other and like charges attracts each other. Like charges means positive charges or negative charges. They will repel each other. And unlike means negative positive or positive negative charges. Now, for main points regarding force is, it should be remembered by you, force is a vector quantity, means it has magnitude as well as direction. If you are asked to apply the force, you will apply the force in a certain direction only. Force has its magnitude and direction both. That is why its magnitude, its value will be there, and it will be applied in the direction. Mass and speed acquired by the body are important parameter to determine the magnitude of force. If you are applying the force, your amount of force can be calculated by the object, mass of the object, and what speed is gained by the object, or what the speed is reduced by the object. That will be the important parameter regarding this thing. So, next is SI unit of force is Newton. It is written, if you are writing the Newton in a small, then it will be unit. If you will write here in capital, then it will be the name of the scientist. But the symbol is capital N. Fifth point, important point regarding force is measured by simple device called as a spring balance. You may see in your book, there is a figure of a spring balance. Now, question arises that what do you mean by Newton, or what do you mean by one Newton? First of all, it is the SI unit of force, and it is defined as force is said to be one Newton if it produces an acceleration of 1 meter per second square in a body of mass 1 kg. If force, you are applying the force and it produces acceleration of 1 meter square and the mass of the body is 1 kg, then the force is said to be 1 Newton. Similarly, here a question arises that what do we mean by acceleration? Then acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity. That is, acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken, and its unit is meter per second square. Now come to the nature of force. It could be any push or pull. Nature is push or pull. It arises due to interaction between two objects. Without two objects, it will not be arise. It can act on an object with or without being in contact. If it arises due to contact, then it will be contact force. If there is no contact, then it will be action at a distance force or non-contact force. It has both direction and magnitude. These are the four factors which decide the nature of the force. Now, what will be the effect of the force? If you are applying the force on any body, then what effect will be arises? It may cause change in the state of rest of an object. State of rest may be changed. It causes change in the state of motion, a speed of the body. It may cause change in size and shape of the object. That means it will change the configuration of the body. It may change the direction of motion. If the object force is applied not in the direction of motion or opposite, if it is applied obliquely, then it will change the direction of motion also. Now come to the balanced force. What do we mean by balanced force? It is in your syllabus in standard 8. So I am defining here balanced force. Balanced force means it has two forces. The pair of forces acting on the same body from opposite direction, due to which the body do not change its position or state of rest or motion, is called balanced force. Okay? The pair of forces acting on the same body as shown in the figure here. In this case, the net force will be zero. In the case of the balanced force, if you calculate the resultant force or net force, the net force will be zero because the magnitude of the forces are same, and but the direction is opposite, so its resultant will be calculated by negative, by difference of the forces. And as it is vector, so you have to write arrow on the force, on the symbol. So in this case, this is the example. First example, F is applied along left hand side and F is applied along right hand side. What will happen? This body will not move. As like in the tug of war. Tug of war is the game in which 4 or 5 people from other side and 4 or 5 people from first side, they start tightening the rope and they will remain in static situation. That is the game. So here is the same. F is applied left hand side and F is applied on right hand side on this object. So the net force will be F. This is a, if it will be minus, it will be plus. So in the right hand direction, force will be positive, and in the left hand direction, the force will be negative. So F minus F is equal to zero. If the force is applied in the towards the body, but these two forces are from different side. It is towards the body, but forces are applied opposite to each other. In this case also, the net force will be zero. Now come to unbalanced force. Unbalanced force is defined as when two forces acting on an object are different, due to which the object undergoes a change in its state of rest or motion, then the pair of different forces is called unbalanced force. Here the forces, magnitude of the forces will be different, and a direction of application may be different, may be same, but the resultant force will not be zero. It will change the state of rest or motion. It may change the position of the object. So how to calculate net force? How to calculate net force? As previously we have, here the net force will not be zero. In the case of unbalanced force, the net force will not be zero. Here I have considered how to calculate the net force, and we have taken example here. When unbalanced forces acting in the direction, in the same direction, what will happen? They will be added up. They will be added up. Resultant will meet you by adding the two forces as F1 and F2. Here F is not written. Here F1 and F2 means magnitudes are different. First situation here, F1 and F2 acting on a body. What will happen? F1 and F2 will combine and it will called as net force, as a one single force. So F is net force or F net. Here F is the unbalanced force. What will happen? This body will start moving in this direction. It will acquire some velocity. It will start moving. And now when unbalanced forces acting in opposite direction, what will happen? If they are opposite direction, they will also combined by subtraction. They will also combined by subtraction. Matlab one force will be negative to the first force. Therefore, addition will be as like subtraction. The net force is equal to the difference between the two forces directed in the direction of the large force. The net force will be along the direction of large force. One is large. Here, I have considered F1 is larger than F2. What will happen? The body will move along the F1 direction. So the resultant will be along F1 direction, and resultant will be calculated by difference of these two forces. Here the directed along F1, that is why here I have written here. In the second figure, you can see forces F1 and F2 are there, but F1 is larger. What will happen? This body will move towards the direction of application of F2. left hand side. First in first case right hand side, and in second case it will move along left hand side. So net force will be not equal to F1 and F2, F1 minus F2. Here F2 is larger, so F2 minus F1, that will be the net force, and it is directed towards the F2. So frictional, now come to next, the frictional force, in detail frictional force will be in the next chapter, but here definition is important to know. And interacting interlocking force acting between two surfaces in contact opposite to the direction of motion of the body is called friction force. Friction force is nothing, when one object is kept over other, they will interlock, the molecules of the two object will start attracting, and they interlocked, due to which friction force arises. It always acts opposite to the applied force or opposite to the motion of the body. Motion of the body, opposite to the direction of motion of the body. It depends upon the nature of surfaces in contact. If the surfaces are rough, then the force will, frictional force will be more. If the surfaces are smooth, the frictional force will be less. Number two, weight of the body or pressing force by the body. If the heavy body is kept on the surface, the friction between surface and body will be large. If lighter body is kept on the surface, then the frictional force will be small. So my dear student, in standard 8, under topic force, this is the concept covered, and activities, you may go through the book and read the activities, and you will be more clear concept. Thank you.